Hello, we are discussing about GATE 1994 ECE paper and the topic we are discussing is electronic devices. This is third 5-mark question came in GATE 1994. The question is related to the CMOS inverter. And CMOS inverter, we know that one, it consisting of two transistors, one is NMOS, the other is PMOS. A typical CMOS inverter has voltage transfer characteristics as shown. Evaluate the value of inverter threshold, which is the value of the input at which V0 falls abruptly by delta V0, which is the VTN plus VTP. The additional information given is beta N is equal to beta P, that is transconductance of NMOS is same as transconductance of PMOS, and threshold voltage of NMOS VTN is given as 1 volt and threshold voltage of PMOS VTP is minus 1 volt. And the power supply using is VDD is 5 volts. For the given diagram of CMOS inverter, we need to calculate inverter threshold. So now we'll see how to solve this problem. We know that one CMOS inverter will be consisting of two transistors. One is NMOS, the other is PMOS. M1 is NMOS transistor, M2 is PMOS transistor. This bubble signifies it is opposite of the below transistor. If there is a bubble, that is PMOS, there is no bubble, that is NMOS, and it is CMOS inverter, this is logic symbol for the inverter. Inverter will give inversion of input signal as output. So if you provide A, you will get output as A bar. If input is A, output is A bar, and this is a CMOS inversion, and we'll see the first operation. Let us assume you are going to give V input as 0, that is, let us assume input signal is going to be logic low. By that time, NMOS will be off condition and PMOS will be in the on condition. NMOS will be off and PMOS will be on condition for the low level. So that this is effective, this is going to be the diagram, equivalent model when V input is equal to 0. NMOS act as off, that is nothing but open circuit. PMOS act as on, that is nothing but short circuit. So now output node V0 is going to be connecting towards VDD through PMOS. So output is VDD when input is 0. When V input is equal to VDD, by that time NMOS will be in the on condition and PMOS will be in the off condition. So PMOS act as open circuit and NMOS act as short circuit. So this is the equivalent diagram for the second case when V input is equal to VDD. So now the output node is going to be connecting to the ground through NMOS and output will be equal to 0 volts. So whenever you apply input as VDD, output will be 0. That is, logic 1 input will give logic 0 output. Similarly, logic 0 input will give the logic 1 output. So, and if you are strictly observing, here we are going with only two discrete values. One is with V input is equal to 0, the other is with V input is equal to VDD. What happens in between these values if you apply as input? So we know that one, NMOS will be in the off condition until the VGS voltage is going to be equal to or greater than threshold voltage. So NMOS will be off until V input is going to be reaching the VTN, that is threshold voltage of NMOS, that is nothing but 1 volt for this given problem. So whenever V input is less than 1 volt, by that time NMOS will be in the off condition and PMOS will be in the on condition. So similarly towards VDD also, if input is going to be lesser than VDD by a small amount, by that time PMOS will be in the off condition and NMOS will be in the on condition. So always logic levels, not a discrete values, logic levels are going to be a range of values. So we can draw the characteristics in this way for the CMOS inverter. So during the initial portion of low voltage level, where the M1 transistor, that is NMOS, is off and PMOS, which is M2, that is on. So this is the region 1 over which NMOS is off and PMOS is on, and region 3 is similarly where NMOS is on and PMOS is off. In between, we are going to get a region where transition is going to be taking place. Now look at this one. Output is changing from VOH to VOL, that is VDD towards 0. So during this transition, both transistors are in the on condition. Both transistors are in on condition is nothing but both will be in the saturation region. So these are VTC, voltage transfer characteristics of CMOS inverter. We need to calculate switching threshold, that is logic threshold, for this CMOS inverter. First we will see what is meant by logic threshold. Look at this one. This is voltage transfer characteristics where we are going with V0 versus V input. So this is the point. V0 is equal to V input is equal to 0. And if you are going to be drawing a line, a straight line with a slope of 1, that is V0 is equal to V in. At that time this is the line which is going to be crossing the VTC, crossing the voltage transfer characteristics at point C. At this point V out is equal to V in on the CMOS characteristics, and this point is also referred as switching threshold point, VSP. VSP at which V0 is equal to V input. At point C, both M1 and M2 are going to be in the saturation region, and at that point output voltage is equal to input voltage. This point is called as logic threshold point or switching threshold point or inversion threshold point or simply logic inversion point. Why it is called like this? Because we know that one, exactly at that point V out is equal to V input. If the input voltage is going to be slightly less than this one, if the input voltage is less than this one, by that time if you draw a vertical line, you will get the output voltage at that point as above VSP. If the input voltage is below VSP, definitely your output voltage will be above VSP. If input voltage is above VSP at that time during this portion, and your output voltage will be below VSP. So this is the point where transition is going to be taking place. If you apply lesser than this voltage as input, you will get more than this voltage as output, and vice versa. So we can define switching threshold or inversion inverter threshold is defined as a point on the voltage transfer characteristics, is the point on the voltage transfer characteristics at which V input is equal to V output, that is nothing but V inversion. It is also called as Vm. So this is the meaning of switching threshold point. If V input is less than V inversion, then V naught is going to be greater than V inversion, and vice versa. For ideal inverter, this switching threshold point is going to be occurring exactly at the middle of power supply. That is V inversion is equal to Vm is equal to VDD by 2. So that is going to be giving the equal noise margins for high level as well as for the low level. Next, this switching threshold point can be calculated graphically from the intersection of VTC with the line V input is equal to V out. Graphically we can easily calculate this point. That is on the transfer characteristics of CMOS, that is voltage transfer characteristics on the CMOS, you are going to be drawing a straight line whose slope is equal to 1, that is V0 is equal to Vin, where it is touching the VTC curve. At that time that point is going to be treated as VTC, that point is treated as threshold point. At this point both the transistors are in on condition, that is nothing but both NMOS and PMOS will be in the saturation region. But we need to calculate analytically, not graphically. So we will see how to calculate inverter threshold voltage analytically. We know that one, at inversion point both the transistors are in saturation, and if you observe what is the relation between the current flowing through M2 and current flowing through M1, that is current flowing through PMOS and current flowing through NMOS. Can we say that one same current is flowing through both the transistors? If you observe, current is coming from VDD and it is flowing through drain, and the same current is flowing through source of M2. Always remember that one, drain current is same as source current. And source of this current, source of M2 is nothing but drain of M1. So the same current which is flowing in source of M2, which is also flows through the drain of M1, that is also flows through the source of M1. So same current flows through PMOS as well as NMOS. No current will go towards gate side because gate is insulated by SiO2 layer. So there is no interaction, direct interaction between the drain to gate or source to gate. They are isolated with the help of silicon dioxide layer. So we can say that one, current flowing through NMOS is same as current flowing through PMOS. So that is nothing but IDN is equal to IDP. And both are in the saturation region. And we know the equation for the saturation region. Beta by 2 into VGS minus VT whole square. So if you use that equation, VGS, VG is nothing but V input. V input is nothing but VSP. We are going to calculate inverse saturation threshold voltage. Here VSP implies nothing but, in this case, this is VGS for M1 transistor. NMOS transistor, that is nothing but for this one, VGS is nothing but V input, VG minus VS. VG is at V in, VS is at ground. So VGS is nothing but V in, it will become V input is equal to V inversion, because we are calculating inverter threshold point. Next, for PMOS, what we can write, beta P by 2 into VGS, VSG minus VT whole square. VSG minus VT whole square. VSG is nothing but VS, this is VDD, minus VG. So VSG is nothing but VDD minus this V input. V input is nothing but V inversion. So VSG for PMOS can be written as VDD minus VSP. So this is what we have written, VDD minus VSP, which is the actually VSG minus VTP whole square. So we are using the drain current in saturation equation, and we are substituting the corresponding gate and source voltages so that you are getting this equation. From this equation, simplify this one and get VSP value. So you are going to be writing an equation for VSP from this one. By that time it will be looks like this one. VSP finally what we will get is beta n by beta p into VTHn plus VDD minus VTP by 1 plus square root of beta n by beta p. This is a switching threshold point or inversion threshold point for the CMOS inverter, and we can calculate it using equation. This is, now we will switch on to the our question. In the question it is given that one, beta n is equal to beta p. So this VSP can be changes to, since beta n is equal to beta p, this will be changes to VTn plus VDD minus VTP by 1 plus 1, that is nothing but 2. Substitute the corresponding values. 1 plus 5 minus 1. So this this is 5 by 2, which is nothing but 2.5 volts. The value of inversion threshold point or switching threshold point is nothing but 2.5 volts for the given problem. But how can we confirm that one? Whenever input is going to be at switching threshold point, how the V0 can abruptly change by VTN plus VTP? This is what mentioned in the problem. At switching threshold point, the V0 can abruptly changes by VTN plus VTP. That is what delta V0, it is indicated in the characteristics. How can we prove? So we know that one, NMOS transistor, if it is has to be in saturation, if NMOS transistor has to be in saturation, the condition is nothing but you must apply gate to source voltage greater than VT. That is nothing but gate to source voltage for M1 is nothing but V input. So V input should be greater than VT0 of N, that is NMOS threshold voltage, and VDS of NMOS should be greater than VGS minus VT. So VDS should be greater than VGS minus VT. VDS is nothing but drain to source voltage of M1, which is nothing but V0. So we can write finally V0, V V output should be greater than or equal to V input minus VT naught, because VDS for NMOS is V naught and VGS for NMOS is nothing but V in. So we can write one equation, V out should be greater than or equal to V input minus VTN. So V output can take a value up to V input minus VT naught for NMOS VTN. So that still NMOS will be in the on condition only, that is in saturation. Similarly for PMOS, the PMOS transistor operates in saturation if V input is less than VDD plus VTP. Here VTP value is minus 1, remember that. So if V input is less than VDD plus VTP, then the PMOS transistor will be in saturation. Okay. Here also we are saying the and if VDS, one more condition is nothing but VDS should be less than VGS minus VT naught. For PMOS we can say it as VSD should be greater than VSG minus VT. Otherwise we can write it as VDS should be less than or equal to VGS minus VT. So VDS for the PMOS, VDS for the PMOS is nothing but V naught minus VDD. VGS for the PMOS is nothing but V input minus VDD. VDD, VDD will get cancelled. That is source, source will get cancelled. What you will get is nothing but VD should be less than or equal to VG minus VT. VD is nothing but V out, VG is nothing but V input minus VT naught P. If you observe these two things, what we can conclude? The output voltage can take a value which is from less than V input by VTN at threshold point. Okay, both the transistors are in saturation and input voltage, that is output voltage, can be lesser by input voltage till VTN. Otherwise V output can be greater than V input minus VTP. VTP is negative value, so minus into minus it will become plus. So this you can write it as V in plus 1, whereas this can be written as V in minus 1. If you are observing, the difference between these two things is around plus 2 volts. That is nothing but that is equal to VTN plus VTP. So V output can change from plus VTN to VTP. V output can change in between VTN to VTP around threshold point, without changing the region of operation of NMOS and PMOS. So NMOS and PMOS won't change the operation of their saturation, but V naught can change value of its by around VTN plus VTP around switching threshold point. Hence we can say that when V naught can have any value between two extremes, that is V naught can change by VTN plus VTP when V input is VSP.